Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at how you can use the Flipper Zero to program an ATtiny85. The ATtiny85 is a small integrated circuit, but it still has 5 to 6 pins of GPIO. I wanted to create an inexpensive device that displays a value based on the analog voltage. We send our data to the MAX7219 chip, and then that connects to an 8x8 matrix or a 7-segment display. The ATtiny85 has analog to digital conversion, similar to the Flipper Zero we looked at earlier. I modified the Flipper Zero JavaScript code from this video so that it drives a 7-segment display, and then I converted that code into ATtiny85 calls. In this video, I'm using the ATtiny85, but the same techniques can be used to program other microprocessors using the Flipper Zero. Let's get started. We'll be using two Flipper Zero applications in this video. If you're on Official or some flavors of Unleashed, you'll need to install them from lab.flipper.net. The process is straightforward. Just go to the website, search for AVR, click on Install on the AVR Flasher app, and then search for Reader and choose the GPIO Reader and say Install as well. Again, Roguemaster and Momentum have them installed, as does Extra Apps in Unleashed. Next, install the Arduino IDE from arduino.cc. You can choose to donate and you can choose to subscribe. Your install experience may be slightly different since I've already run the Arduino IDE in the past. Once it's downloaded, click Open File. The installation process will take a few moments, and then once it's complete, you should have an icon on your desktop. You should be able to open the IDE, but again, since this isn't my first run, I'm not sure what the experience is that you'll see. If you do a File New Sketch, you should definitely see the Setup and Loop call. The next step is File, Preferences, and then under Additional Board Manager URLs, open that up, and then paste in the URLs of your board manager. I'll put these URLs in the video description. Click OK to update those URLs. I also recommend Verbose Upload Output, and then OK to save your changes. Open Tools, then Board Manager. In the filter box, type in Tiny, and you should see ATtiny and ATtinyCore. Go ahead and click Install on ATtiny. And then once that's installed, go to ATtinyCore and click Install. You may need to install various drivers. I think in the filter, instead of typing in Tiny, if we had done Tiny85, it would have shown us just the two board managers we cared about. Leave a comment below to let people know which board manager you prefer. In my blink sketch, I've listed the flipper pins and the ATtiny85 pins. Pins 4 and 7 on the flipper are not required for programming. There's a notch in the chip next to pin 1. On the left side, we have pins 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, 6, 7, 8. Pin 2 on the flipper goes to pin 5 on our Tiny85. That's MOSI. Pin 3 on the flipper goes to pin 6 on our 85. That's MISO. Pin 4 on our flipper goes to pin 3. This is just the optional clock. We're not actually using that for the clock. Pin 5 on our flipper goes to pin 7 on our Tiny85. And this is the serial clock. Pin 6 on our flipper goes to pin 1 on our Tiny85. This is the reset line. Pin 7 on our flipper goes to pin 2 on our Tiny85. And this is not used in programming. This is just used by the sketch later. And then pin 8 or 11 or whatever ground on your flipper is going to go to pin 4 on the Tiny85. And then finally, the 3.3 on the flipper, pin 9, goes to pin 8 on the Tiny85. So here it is all wired up. So we have all 8 pins of our ATtiny85 going to the 8 pins of our flipper zero. We'll power up our flipper zero, and then we'll go into apps, GPIO, and then AVR flasher. And then under ISP programmer, you should see AVR chip detected, ATtiny85. To make it a little easier, I used this prototype board from Make It Hackin and added a 8-pin dip socket so I can just put in my chip and go. I'll paste in the blink INO sketch. And this program just blinks each of the GPIO pins, except we don't use ATtiny pin 1, which is the reset pin. With the sketch loaded, we'll go into tools, and then we'll choose board. And then for this time through, we'll choose the ATtiny board, and then the ATtiny 254585. Again, on your flipper zero, you're going to go into apps, GPIO, AVR flasher. Make sure all the wires are connected properly. Go to ISP programmer. It should detect your ATtiny85 and then click next. The flipper should show ISP mode active and the USB cable will expose a new serial port. Choose tools and then port and select the serial port that your flipper zero is running the ISP programmer as. Next, choose tools and get board info. This should show the VID and PID, and the serial number should be the name of your flipper. Next, we'll choose tools and then clock, and then either internal 1 megahertz or internal 8 megahertz. 1 megahertz uses less power, and make sure the processor says ATtiny85. Under tools programmer, choose Arduino as ISP. The other option that seems to work is to choose programmer AVR ISP. And then choose tools and burn bootloader. And this will set the processor to either that 1 megahertz or 8 megahertz that you specified. And now we're ready to upload our sketch. So go into sketch and then upload using programmer. This will compile your sketch and then it will upload it to the ATtiny85. Our sketch is now uploaded and running, so we'll go ahead and back out, go into GPIO reader, and on pin PA7, every so often, you should see a little blink going high, low, high, low, high, low. Switching to the next pin, PA6, it blinks after PA7, there it is. So if everything's connected correctly, PA7 followed by PA6, PA4, PB3, and PC3 should be blinking. PB2 does not blink, that's the reset wire, and we did not use that pin in our sketch. I put the board back in ISP programming mode. Now let's take a look at ATtiny Core. Choose Tools, Board, ATtiny Core, ATtiny254585, no bootloader. Make sure Tools port is set correctly, and then do Get Board Info. Next, choose Tools and then Chip, and make sure your chip is set to ATtiny85. Tools Clock Source, and we can set it to 8 MHz internal or that 1 MHz internal if you want to save power. There's some other options under Tools, such as the Millis, that'll save some memory if you disable it. Make sure Programmer is set to Arduino as ISP or AVR ISP. And then click on Burn Bootloader. This will set your processor to the speed you've specified. And then under Sketch, use Upload Using Programmer. And this will compile your program and upload it to the processor. And then under GPIO Reader, we can watch the pins as they blink and switch pins. The last thing I wanted to show is how you can dump and flash AVR images. So go ahead and back out. And then choose Dump AVR. It should detect the chip. Go ahead and click Next. We'll name the dump file as Blink, and then click Save, and then click OK to start. At this point, it's reading and verifying what it read, and you should get success. Then in the future, go to Flash AVR. It'll detect your chip, say Next, And then you can pick that blank file that you saved, or you could pick a different file that you've saved. We'll load the counting dump and then click OK to start. It's flashing our firmware. And then verifying that the flash was correct. And there you go. And click on exit. And now we can try our new application. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, leave them below or contact me on Discord.